So my name is Ryan Graham. I'm the Chief Technical Officer here at Texthelp. So, I mean, obviously over the past couple of years, there's been a massive shift in education towards education technology. We've seen the uptake of LMSs, assigning homework digitally, and that's going to stay around. We're not going to go back to sending home pages and pages of homework. I think you're going to see a lot more digital learning as we go through the year. I think teachers and students have now got into that way of using their devices, and which is a great thing as well from an accessibility point of view too, because the materials that we are producing now digitally allow people to consume them in many more different ways and in many more different formats. It allows students to open up their assignments on a phone or on a tablet or on a computer. So I do think that's the way things are going to go in the next year as well. So it's definitely early days for AR and VR. I think in education there's a whole world of possibilities there. I mean, obviously having the ability to go to a field trip within your own classroom to really immerse students in learning without having to leave the classroom is absolutely fantastic. There is unlimited possibilities there in terms of the learning that we could do in a classroom. Having said that, that's got a long way to go. It's got a long way to go from a cost perspective. You know, the schools are struggling these days with the rising costs for everything, and bringing AR and VR into the classroom is going to be an even more expensive thing to do. I also think there's work there to be done in terms of the accessibility of those platforms. It very often can be an afterthought for AR and VR, and if we are going to commit to doing that and bringing those experiences to the classrooms, we want to bring those experiences for everybody and not just a select few. So the metaverse is somebody's idea to sit down and try to make AR and VR happen and try to make it feasible, which is the right thing to do. It is the right thing to do. And I think if they can figure out the cost issues, if they can figure out the accessibility issues, then the metaverse is absolutely a viable thing for education and for classrooms as well in the future. So AI and machine learning could have a massive impact on learning going forward. I mean, we're looking at models and services this year even, that have the ability to write essays for you. You can ask the machine to write you an essay about Macbeth from the perspective of Roger Rabbit, and it will go and do it, and it will do a pretty good job as well. I really think our entire education system needs to be taking learnings from this. We really need to see how this fits into our future education systems as well, because if it can write all these things on behalf of a student, we really need to identify what is the student's work and what is the work of a machine as well. So that, I think, has the ability to have a profound impact on the way that we ask students to write long form and write essays and written content in general. I think it also has a massive benefit too, and there are students who really struggle to write and understand long form content, and AI and ML, if used properly, can be a massive benefit for those students, particularly those ones who are struggling, to be able to give them parity with their peers in the way that they write and the way that they understand content. But there is a skill there to, if you tell the machine to write something for you and you can get good information back out of it, that's a skill in itself to be learned, and I think that's something that we really need to think about in children's education.